Kai, over here. Do you left, mate? Congratulations on the win.
Thank you.
I'm sure you're expecting the win, but were you expecting it like that?
I visualized this, and I knew the finish would come. I just knew Cody doesn't take me serious.
Yeah.
I told him all week at media. I said, don't worry about Sean, worry about me. And he just brushed it off. He said, what am I worried about you for? I feel like he didn't respect me as an opponent. He told me, you beg for this. And I had a point to prove tonight. Bantamweights can't just drop down to flyweight and think they can bang and think they can bully us. And with all the momentum now, two first round knockouts, taking out a former champ, I feel like it's my time.
Title shot next.
You know, if I'm a matchmaker, Mick, he did say, he didn't say yes or didn't say no when our management said to him, Kai's next for a title shot. So I think I made a statement tonight, taking out a former champ. It's a great story tale. Brandon Moreno versus Figueiredo, you know, they've done it three, this will be the third time they're fighting. I fought Brandon 2 years ago, 3 years ago back in 2019. It was a close fight. And he's done well since then. He's improved a lot, but so have I. And I feel like the other flyweights that I guess were ahead of me in the rankings, they're not here tonight. I'm here. It was my show tonight. So I feel like I've leapfrogged them, and I'll be next in line for the title shot. So I'll be the matchmaker. I can predict the future. Let's bring the UFC down to New Zealand. Let's do the flyweight title down there. I know we'd love it, and it's about time. UFC came back down to our hometown.
You mentioned that you don't think he took you seriously. Do you think that's because he was dropping from bantamweight and he kind of just felt like the bigger guy and that sort of stuff, you know?
Oh, definitely. You know, these...
Nah, you're just that good, Cody. That's it. Yeah. So you gotta take it. You're just that good. He's good. He's a former champ, but you're better. You're
there the we best. Go. Talk your shit, Dan. But I know I'm the best. I know I'm the best in the world. I know I'm the best in the world, and tonight I proved that. Tonight I proved that I'm next in line for the title. I felt so calm in there tonight. I didn't feel any pressure. The pressure was all on him. And that's his bad if he didn't take me seriously, because it could have been his retirement fight. So when I knocked him out and then I walked over to him, you know, I just told him, you're a legend in the sport, nothing but respect. There's no animosity. There's nothing personal, it's just business. And that's what I said to him.
Did you anticipate once you hit him hard once, he would kind of get a little bit crazy? Like,
I knew that's when he's most dangerous, when he gets hurt. And I knew when I clipped him, when I landed and found the shot, it was the beginning of the end. And before he knew it, you know, he was trying to go for a double leg. And that's when you know that's not in his nature, you know, he doesn't do that. So yeah, I knew he was hurt then. And I just had to listen to my corners. They were saying, just faint, just draw it out of him. And don't get hit with, you know, a lucky shot. And eventually we found the button and we put him away. So pretty special moment. My wife and my son were in the crowd tonight. My son's first event. He's only 9 months old. So he had his earmuffs on. So pretty cool to, more than cool. Just special to know that's his dad out there. And, you know, this was for New Zealand. I know we've been doing it rough on all these lockdowns and restrictions. So I know back home they're celebrating. And, you know, we'll be celebrating tonight in Vegas as well.
Yeah, I was going to ask you, Ty, those guys, how big's the party tonight?
Woo, it's going to be the Kai and Ty show tonight, I think. it's well deserved. You know, just to get to Vegas, you know, we've been through a lot. So you got to celebrate the wins, as Dan Hooker says.
Congratulations.
Appreciate it.
Kai, over here, there was a back and forth between O'Malley and Garbrandt during the press conference this week, and you just sat there in between them, and no one asked you anything, and I was wondering what was going through your mind as these two were acting as if they were in the main event during the press conference.
I guess, I knew what I was bringing to the table. I don't need to talk about it. I don't need to, I guess, be loud and try to force my way into that confrontation. You know, we're going to fight at the end of the day, and I back myself. You know, I know I'm the best in the world, so I was going to let my talking do the I was going to let my work do the talking tonight. So when I stared across from Cody when we did that media day, I told him, don't worry about Sean, worry about me, and he brushed it off like I was nothing. He thought he was, going to take over the flyweight division. So I just shut that off tonight, and I might have retired him. But it's just what we do at City Kickboxing. You know, we fight the best in the world. I know we've got the best gym in the world, and we proved that tonight. So we're pretty special, and just lucky to have all my teammates here, and I can't wait to see what the future holds.
Can I hear in the back? What did you make of Garbrandt striking while you were inside the cage with him? Because obviously he's heralded as just, you know, a really hard-hitting puncher, but what did you make of his striking?
I've never been hit with, the three ninjas, that little kick they do when they slide on the ground. I've never been kicked with something like that, but I was actually impressed. I was like, oh, yo, Cody's actually mixing it up now, not just relying on his hands. So I was like, oh, I'm excited to see what he's going to bring to me. When I stepped in the ring and I had ring control, and I was like, oh, I want to see what he brings. I want the best Cody. But once I started fainting and I started getting reactions, I knew that, I can put it on him now. And then once I landed that first shot, I knew it was the beginning of the end. So, you know, one of the best boxers in the UFC, but he's had his time. It's long overdue, and now it's my time. So I've got all the momentum now. You know, there's no other flyweight doing what I'm doing in the division. And I've got my second first round knockout, it's just the momentum now. So I feel like it's my time. I want that title shot against Brandon Moreno if he gets past Figueiredo, which I feel like he will. You're seeing it now. Early 2022, I'll be getting that title shot.
Well, that kind of answers my next question, which was if you have a preference for Moreno and Figueiredo, and it sounds like you clearly do. Do you have a message for the current champ?
Hey, Moreno. Let's get the rematch going, bro. But I know he's got business to take care of, but I feel like he will, do the same that he did to Figueroa in the second fight. And I'll wait. I'll wait for that title fight. I'll wait for that rematch. It's an exciting fight. There's a lot of guys that, a lot of guys in this division, but they're not here tonight. You know, I was here. I put on a show. I took out a former champ. I've got my ticket. I think I've earned it.
And you mentioned that you would like to have a title fight in New Zealand, but you also said there's a lot of restrictions and lockdowns and stuff like that. Do you think it is realistic in the foreseeable future?
Well, we're opening up. New Zealand's opening up in April to international travelers. So anytime after April, the UFC could come to New Zealand and we could get it done. So, you know, if New Zealand is a bit too hard, Australia is the next best place. You know, that they're opening up as well. And just to get a card down those ways would do everything for us. You know, we'll be definitely missing the UFC, missing live fights. It's not the same. So, me and Ty putting on a show tonight just shows that it's about time the UFC came back down.
And as you mentioned, Ty, you said it's going to be the Kai and Ty show tonight. Does that mean we're going to see a couple of shoeys from you?
I don't know. I keep telling the boys, keep Ty away from me, but it's inevitable. Dan keeps saying unnegotiable, so I guess it's just get them going. Let's go.
All right, sounds good. Great
appreciate
job.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
Hey, Kai, I was wondering, you know, you obviously talked about it. Usually it's the whole team, but now is all the focus on you.
Yeah.
Not as many of the guys are here with you. Can you just talk about how they were staying in touch with you and sending all that energy from New Zealand?
Yeah, so this week's been a bit difficult in regards to, normality with our coaching. But, you know, I trust my team, and I've got so much wisdom and knowledge that I knew I was in good hands. Even though Eugene wasn't here, our head coach, I knew the game plan. We've been doing this for so long, working on the game plan for Cody Garbrandt for the last 3-4 months. So I was focused, you know, I knew exactly what we needed to do. But that just comes down to my preparation and teammates that helped me prepare for this fight. Just staying calm, cool, collective. In these high-pressure moments, no pressure was on me. You know, I just felt at home. I felt like all the pressure was on Cody. And, eventually we just had to find the shot. So I'm glad it all worked out, and I got the job done.
If usually when Adesanya fights, they seem to invite the rest of the guys more of a party. Yep. They did make it official for February. If they say, hey, Kai, do you want to be part of it in February? Is that too soon?
I'll do it if there's a title shot. If it's a title shot against Brandon, then I'll do it. But unless it's not a title shot, I'll wait. You know, what's the rush? You know, I put on a show tonight. I got the finish. My second first round knockout in the flyweight division. So I feel like I can wait for that title shot.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Anyone else? Appreciate it, guys. Thank you.